Stefan, great to have you back. After a very successful test of your hunt last year.
Yeah.
Also was a tough one.
Yeah.
But I think today is going to be on the next level.
Looking to do the first Impala Slam.
Yeah.
Today, and we're gonna try and film the whole thing for our Africa's Sportsman Show, and hopefully we can record a nice memory. It's going to be tough. There's Impala all over available, and a lot of guys have hunted them, but it can happen that an Impala can give you a run for your money. So to try and hunt four on one day is going to be tough. I mean, if we don't succeed in that, we're still going to try and complete the slam. But we would like to try and accomplish it in one day. We've also, I've brought along various rifles. We tried to match a rifle to the, or the bullet or whatever, to the color of the Impala. But we'll elaborate on that later. We have all, like you said, all four colors available.
Yeah.
I think we're going to start off, like you said, with the common Impala. There's a lot of them.
Yeah.
So let's get our. I brought my 7.64 in a Tikka, common hunting rifle. It's for the common Impala. And because it's the red one of the lot, I'm using Hornady Interbonds with a red tip. So, and I think let's head off. The sun is up already, so we have a long day ahead of us.
Yeah, I'm looking forward.
Really looking forward. Thanks, Marco. For the common Impala, I brought along, this is my 7x64 Brennecke. It's an Atika M695 model. I've had this for, yes, over 20 years now. So, it's a very special gun to me. Just a normal, common hunting rifle, and that's what we're going to use for the common Impala. And because of its red color, the Hornady Interbond bullets with the red tips. So, We spotted some Impala about 200-300 meters from us over an open patch. They disappeared into the thicket, so we're gonna try and make a stalk. Hopefully we're lucky with a nice cold morning. They won't go far. Okay, Mark, you ready?
I think let's just go over that hill and see if we can find something at the bottom.
Okay. They must be on my life. I've only seen females, but they're all inside there.
Well, they have busted us.
Yeah, they saw us, but we're still far away. So.
Yeah.
How far are those ones on the left?
47. We saw some more females. I think the herd was bigger than we thought. So let's see if we can flush out a male maybe out of this.
And we spotted a very nice white flank Impala. So we're going to do a quick caliber change. We're going to use a Nosler rifle during the white tipped Nosler Accubonds for this specific ram. There's some good common Impala with him as well. But let's give it a go for that white flank. It is around the open area here at the back.
Yeah.
So there's a good chance that we're going to have to take a longer shot.
That's...
So feeling good with a 6.5-284. So let's just try and keep the wind in our favor. And then I don't think we need to shoot further than 250. If we can keep it under that.
I'm sure we will.
From these sticks.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Busted once again, Marco.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wind turned on us.
The wind turned on us in the last second. Made a dash for it yet to this open field, but to no avail. So let's start from scratch.
we spotted a very nice common Impala walking with some water buck, and the wind is perfect. So
let's try.
I'm gonna give it a go.
Still coming. Okay. He's down.
Well done, Stefan.
Well, that's what happens if you limit yourself to one gun per animal.
Per animal.
Yes. We had a chance on the black one, then a chance, a couple of chances on the saddleback. That is a monster saddleback.
It's a monster saddleback.
But I think we have a decent common one there.
It's yeah.
Nice and thick horns.
Definitely.
I think you'll definitely find bigger ones, but I mean, yeah, we had to start somewhere. Thank you, Marco.
Perfect arch shot.
Yeah, I think it was a great shot. Was it 160 meters? 0 to 100, 3, 4, 5 inches. The bullet drop worked out perfectly. And well, what a great ram. Huh? This is a nice, mature ram. Look at the thickness of these bases and the thickness of the neck. I think it's an excellent trophy. Well, Marco, this is the first one of the four Impala. We're looking forward to complete the slam here at Nala Safaris. And thank you for picking out a beautiful specimen. This is a special ram. I mean, it's the first one of the four, and it's in top condition. I mean, this thing is going to dress out well over 40 kilograms, and it's got thick bases. I think this is a real trophy in any hunter's book. So thank you.
Thank you, Stefan.
Really looking
great
forward.
Shot.
Oh, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. And really looking forward to the rest of the afternoon.
Me too. Stefan, will you please just explain to us about these two guns?
Marco, so we spotted with this common Impala, we spotted a black Impala. So then I brought along this black rifle, this little Ruger I've been using extensively for the last almost 10 years. So, and it's completely black with a black Leupold scope on. And then for the saddleback, it was difficult trying to come up with something, but this is a classic Mauser rifle. It's one of those 140-year special edition rifles, so it's like the saddleback, yeah. Brown at the bottom with a top of the range black Swarovski scope on top of it. So it's both a 375 calibers. This is a 375 H&H. This is a 375 Ruger, so definitely more than enough gun to take down an Impala. And luckily they stopped in these thick bushes, I don't know, 20 paces later. So yeah, it was a quick one. The saddleback, we saw him go out
just
as well. So
that way.
Yeah. But Marco, how far were they from the first one we shot? I mean, 200 meters, not even.
Yeah.
If that, so.
No, that's very close.
Yeah. This just shows you, eh? Well, everything goes well and you still doubt yourself. Yeah, here he is.
Stefan, well done on your first black Impala with your black rifle. Almost thought we lost him, but luckily it was a good shot and found him about 50 meters further.
Yeah. Thanks, well, Marco. Two left, eh?
Two left.
There's some daylight left, so hopefully we can accomplish this slam in one day. We almost had a chance on that saddleback.
Yep.
So let's go for it. Let's go and look for him.
Good.
Right, that's it. Two down. Two to go. Loaded up with a 375 H&H. Looking for that saddleback Impala. You ready?
Ready. Stefan,
Unfortunately, we didn't get all four. We struggled with the saddleback, got him, and he got away. Same with the white flanked. We saw one nice ram this morning and saw him now again, but now they're into the thick bush, so I don't think we're going to find them now.
Yeah,
sun's going down.
Yeah, it's bad luck. We always knew it was going to be a tough challenge trying to doing it in one day. I had a hell of a day. We hunted our butts off. I mean, you check now and it was almost 15 kilometers we've done on foot for those two we did get. So all in all, a great day's hunting, and hopefully we can finish our slam tomorrow.
Yes, we'll start early and
see what we can find. Get to our jackets quickly. The sun is going down, so
yes.
Thanks.
Thank you, Stefan.
It was a great day.
Thank you.
Morning, Marco.
Morning, Stefan.
We're back here. The moon is busy going down. We're waiting for the sun to come up.
I think we're going to look for those two nice white flank rams first this morning. There's a few rams here, but yeah, we saw those two.
Yeah, we definitely saw two different ones, because the one horn we could definitely see was a little bit misformed, and the other one was in a perfect shape. I mean, it's impossible to say all the time, but we definitely know we saw two separate ones also running with two different herds. So
yeah,
I think
if we see the saddleback, we must take him first, whichever we find.
We have our two guns on the back of the vehicle, so we'll be heading into that area, and the moment the sun comes up, we'll start looking.
Stefan, we just saw that nice white flank impala ram again. They are still in the thick bush, but I think we might have a chance.
I'm not sure. I didn't hear anything.
Looked nice to me.
Yeah, we followed him for, I don't know, 200 meters through the vines and the scuff, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a risky shot. I shouldn't have taken it.
But I think let's just go take a look.
Let's go take a look where he stood and just make sure there's no blood.
Yeah.
We spotted him a couple of hundred meters going into the thick piece of bush here, so... It looks like we did hit him, so if we see him again, we just go...
Yeah.
Sit down.
Okay. Well, that's the one.
Yes, sir. Well, so that means we did clap him on that first shot.
Yeah.
And yeah, he gave us a chance right under this bush, so it means he was heavily hit.
Yeah.
But we got him. And there's the guy. So we made a dash for it, but luckily we could get a shot. And he's down.
Good shooting.
Made us work. Yeah, well, bad decision making, good shooting in the end.
Stefan, finally got him.
Finally got him.
We saw him yesterday morning for the first time.
Yeah, we saw this exact ram.
Yeah.
And we saw another beautiful one as well yesterday with a misformed horn, which is also beautiful. But I think this is the perfect animal for what we're trying to do. I mean, it's got an absolute magnificent coat with all these white hairs coming out here, and he's this complete cream color, you know, just as a normal common impala, you know, just with the whiter coat and then obviously the white face. So yeah. Mark, thank you so much.
Thank you, Stefan.
It was a great hunt this morning. We struggled a bit in that thick bush a couple of 100 meters away. Got a shot, a little bit of a raking shot. Hopefully Cliffy from Savuti can fix it, but I'm sure he will be able to. Thank you so much to Nala Safaris. 75% done.
One more.
Let's try and get one more, and then we can relax and think back on an absolutely wonderful 2 days.
Thank you, Stefan.
Right. Marco, so this is the last one left. We're gonna look for saddleback impala. We're using this beautiful Mauser rifle. Just as a saddleback, brown at the bottom and black on top with a Swarovski Z6. So we're gonna load up and we're gonna head into the wind with the sun on our backs. Is that the plan?
That's the plan. I think if we just work this bush, we might find something.
Yeah, there's a number of saddlebacks here. We saw yesterday a beautiful one walking with that common and that black one. So, but whichever one we get first, I think that's going to be the one.
Definitely.
Not going to be very picky now. Isn't as easy as we thought. So. Now we know it's going to be challenging. So this is the last one left.
Yeah.
Hopefully we can bag him this morning.
Let's find him.
Ik heb gezien hij stopt al. Was bij weer net pikje dikker.
On a saddleback a little bit earlier, but yeah, the rifle slipped off the shooting sticks twice. Well, I let the rifle slip up twice off the shooting stick, so missed opportunity there. Just waiting for some zebra to pass so we don't spook them. Following that general direction of that impala, but I think he's gone.
Stefan, I think he went up, but I think let's just work this bush first and make sure he's not here. And then so we can.
He didn't dash off.
No, not at all. I thought he stood still.
Yeah. Maybe we missed him.
I think
idea.
So.
Let's just work this area again.
Yeah. Stefan. On the left of the waterbuck pool.
He's standing right next to the bull.
Yeah, can you see him?
Okay, well, you ready?
Ready?
Yeah.
Hey Tom, he's flat.
Is he down?
I think he's down.
Okay. I definitely
I'm too scared to say after yesterday, but it looked like
But he's down. Definitely hit him. This gun is zeroed at around about 150 meters. It was too quick to range. So I just took on his back, on the back of the Impala, and we definitely had a big thumb. So
yeah. No, I definitely
let's just,
think.
Let's just reload and proceed carefully and hopefully he's done.
Down.
Marco.
Well done, Stefan.
Thanks, man. Yeah, the shot is a bit high, but I must be honest, through these thick falbos we had to shoot through. But that's where we aimed. So, yeah. Yes, but what a beautiful saddleback. Look how black his back is, eh? Sure. I don't think it's fair to try and distinguish or to choose between the four which one is more special, but I think this is a special one to end it with. I think it's a beautiful specimen. I think you here at Nahala Safaris can be very proud of yourself with the animals.
Thank you, Stefan.
You can provide a hunter with really from the bottom of my heart. Thank you and congratulations. You guys got a real nice setup.
What a ram.
Yes, Marco, for sure. Now I don't know between him and the white flank, you know, which is more rare, but I mean it's not something you see every day, and it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful animal. I didn't know of all the black spots this thing have, you know, here on his rump, on his knees, here at the back, on his hooves, the tips of the ears, that you know, you always hear the name saddleback and you think it's only the back that's got the black markings, but I mean it's a lot with the white tail. I mean it's just an absolute beautiful Impala. So
he kept us busy. Beautiful. Well done, Stefan.
Thank you so much. It was an absolutely great experience this morning.
Thank you.
I really, really enjoyed it.
Stefan, well done on your first Impala slam. I think we have four beautiful animals. It didn't make it easy.
For sure.
And thank you for letting us use four different rifles, each with its own purpose for every animal. I think everything worked out well in the end. And, we didn't finish it in one day, but here we are.
Yeah, Marco, I mean, you can really say that again. I mean, it's just four gorgeous animals, each to its own, as unique as they come, becoming more commonly available in South Africa. Again, not only for the overseas market, but definitely for the local South African market as well. So, I mean, it's just four gorgeous animals, fully grown adult Impala rams with the four color variations. So, with the rifles as well, I think it was cool trying to pair something. I mean, it's just something we thought of a little, you know, just before the hunt. So, but yeah, from my side, I mean, thanks. We've had an awesome hunt, also a challenging hunt. Last year with that Tetsubi, we tried to do the double and also succeeded in the end after struggling a bit. And this one, you know, this hunt went almost perfectly. I mean, except for that one shot I maybe shouldn't have taken on the white flank earlier this morning. I think everything else went perfectly, and some good shooting, some adequate calibers for shooting Impala with. And I just want to compliment you once again on the outfit you run. I mean, the accommodation, the service, you know, the professionalism, you and your staff, you know, treat the client with. It's just a pleasure hunting you with you guys. So from my side, and from Africa Sportsman Show, thank you for having us, and hopefully we can do something nice in the future again.
Thank you, Stefan.
Thanks, Mark.
Thank you.